you to raise both hands in his presence right now. I just want you to adore him. Just give him what you brought for him this morning. What shall I give to him? The great I am. Give him what you bring this morning. Say, Lord, this is my sacrifice to you. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, glory. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. You're exalted. High above all else. We worship. We worship. We worship. Because you alone is worthy. You're glorified. You're exalted. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. We bring the sacrifice of praise into the house of the Lord. And we offer up to you the sacrifices of thanksgiving. We offer up to you the sacrifices of praise. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The 24 elders before the throne, they bow, saying, Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God, slain from the foundation of the earth, for sinners crucified. You are the supreme sacrifice. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Blessed be your name, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Father, I commit myself. I commit my being. I commit my mind. I commit my body. I commit my heart. I commit my lips, my entire being to you right now. Oh God, take my intellect and use every power as thou shalt choose. Take my life this morning and make it wholly thine as I seek to communicate your word. Oh God, I need you. I need you, Lord. Let your Holy Spirit empower us. Let your Holy Spirit speak. Oh God, you know every individual that will hear, oh God, your word this morning. Jesus, you know where we are. You know what matters most. You know what words we need to hear. God, help me as a frail human vessel this morning. Oh, Jesus, that you will speak to me and through me, God. You know I'll give you the glory always. I submit to you, Jesus. Oh, glory. Completely, Jesus. Just have your way this morning. Oh, Jesus. Speak, Lord. Thy servant heareth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Thy will be done. I tell you thanks again. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Just before you take your seat, just reach across and embrace somebody this morning. And just tell them something that the Lord would have you to speak in their spirit. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Oh, Jesus, bring healing, bring restoration, bring deliverance, bring hope, bring reassurance, Lord. Oh, glory to God, bring strength. Oh, God, encourage your people this morning. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord, we love you, we love you, we love you. You're exalted this morning. Thank you, Jesus. God bless you. You can have your seats. I extend my special greetings to our Bishop and Pastor, Bishop Dr. Delford Davis, to all of my ministerial colleagues, to the beautiful Echoes of Faith choir that have ministered and have encouraged us this morning. Come too far. Just can't give up now. Musicians, General Assembly, and just about everyone. Just touch yourself and say, I am special. Because God makes me special. And I'm one of a kind. There's not another me. Only me. Just me. And not another me. And I love myself for who God makes me to be. And I don't want to be nobody else. I just want to be me, as God do his work in me, through me, and for his glory. Hallelujah. Put your hands together and worship the Lord this morning. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. As I seek to communicate the word of God to us this morning, I know the Lord has spoken to me. And I'm believing God this morning through his Holy Spirit that our hearts will be so open and receptive to the word of God that when this service would have concluded, God would have been pleased with the work that his word and his Holy Spirit will do in us this morning. I believe God, and I know he's in the house. I have availed myself to him. And I seek to communicate that which he has given to me. I want you to turn your Bibles with me to the book of 2 Kings chapter 2. 2 Kings chapter 2. And I'll be reading from verse 19 to 22. Second Kings 2 from verse 19 to 22. And it reads thus. And the men of the city said unto Elisha, Behold, I pray thee, the situation of this city is pleasant, as the Lord seeth, but the water is not, and the ground barren. And he said, Bring me a new cruse, and put salt therein. And they brought it to him. And he went forth unto the spring of water, and cast the salt in there, and said, Thus saith the Lord, I have healed these waters. There shall not be from thence any more death or barren land. So the waters were healed unto this day, according to the saying of Elisha, which he spake. Thus saith the Lord, I have healed these waters. Thus saith the Lord, I, the Lord, have healed these waters. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Power of faith. As I seek to minister to us this morning, I bear the team. Let God heal your water. Let God heal your water. And now I want you to touch yourself and say, Lord, heal my water. Lord, heal my water. Glory to God. I don't know if you sincerely mean it, but maybe when I start communicating, you'll understand a little more what the Holy Spirit is saying to us. I know there are a lot of hurting people around. Different circumstances of life are dictating. Persons are going through various situations and circumstances of life. Somebody here this morning, you had a sleepless night. You have drunk your tears. Oh, glory to God. But the Holy Spirit is saying to us this morning, God is in the midst of us. And He's getting ready to heal somebody water. Oh, glory to God. Hey, Jesus, Jesus. I define water in the natural. What is water? Water in the natural is classified as the liquid that fills the ocean, rivers, lakes, ponds, and falls from the sky as rain. That's a type of water that we know. I deliberately choose to tell you what is pure water, because I'll define contaminated water or polluted water also. Pure water is a transparent, colorless, tasteless, odorless compound of hydrogen and oxygen that don't mean much to some. Minister Davis, what is the purpose of water? It varies. Many. Water is very vital or essential to the sustenance of every living thing. Every living thing, whether it be human, whether it be plant, whether it be animal, as long as it has life, it depends on water for its sustenance. It cannot exist for long without water. Water is used for multiplicities of purposes. We wash, we clean, the fields or the crops are irrigated with water. We drink it. We use it for personal hygiene, and the list goes on. This morning, we say, Lord, heal my water. Something is wrong with the water. The water needs healing. It needs cure. It needs to be made whole. Water can be hazardous to one's health. And you said to me, water being so critical and vital to the sustenance of life, then how can it become hazardous when it becomes polluted, when it becomes contaminated? And most time, water that has life, water that continues flowing, it is pure because it continues to flush itself as it continues to flow along. But when water becomes stagnant, when water becomes lifeless, when there is no life to the water, Jesus, my Lord, When water ceases to run or flow, when the water has no movement, but it is stationary, very soon, if that water is not flushed out, it's going to become stagnant. And when the water becomes stagnant, mosquitoes will start breed eggs in the water. Frogs and all different type of creature will start reside in the water. And after a while, the water will start give off a stench, an odor, and a smell, because the water become polluted. Heal my water, Jesus. When a human being consumes polluted water, it's going to cause sickness or ill health. And most time, one of the main spill-off is gastroenteritis, which can become very deadly. It causes vomiting and loose bowels. And that means the body starts to lose its fluid. And when the body starts to lose its fluid, if the body is not replenished with fluid, you're going to start become dehydrated. And after that, if you do not seek medical attention, where most time the doctor give you rehydrating fluid in the form of a salt, where it is mixed in water and taken to take care of that gastroenteritis, if that is not done very soon, death is imminent. You are going to die because the body becomes depleted of all the fluid that keep it alive. The Holy Spirit is saying this morning, some of us have taken polluted or contaminated water, and we are spiritually sick this morning. And if we do not get immediate attention, life is at stake. But the Holy Ghost is here with the rehydrating fluid. The Holy Ghost is here with that special salt this morning. Oh, glory to God. And He wants to administer healing to your polluted water. Thank you, Jesus. I get to the scripture as I continue to lay a little more foundation. Water in the scripture, the symbol of God's salvation. As in the prophecy, that is worshippers who draw water out of the well of salvation. And that is Isaiah chapter 12 and verse 3. The word of God says, therefore with joy shall he draw water out of the wells of salvation. So just like the physical body depends on water for its sustenance, our spiritual life completely depends on the spiritual water in order for us to be a healthy Christian. There are criterias, there are requirements according to Isaiah. Some of us have lost our joy. And the requirement is with joy. The bucket that is allowed to go down in the well is a bucket of joy. So if you don't have any joy, it means that you are not drawing. And because you are not drawing, you are spiritually thirsty. And if you do not get water, very soon, you're likely to die. With joy, you shall come to the well of salvation, and you shall draw. The joy of the Lord is my strength. Let me get a big smile from my Echoes of Faith choir. If it's even a fake, put on a smile. Let the devil see you smile this morning. The billows are dashing. The tempest is raging. But let the devil know, the joy of the Lord is my strength. The Jews use it for ceremonial washing. The Christian considers it essential for water baptism. And as you know, it symbolizes the death, the burial, and the resurrection. You become dead to sin, you are buried with him in water, and you are raised up to walk in the newness of life. Romans 6, verse 3 and 4. Know he not that so as many of us as were baptized in Jesus Christ were baptized in his death? Therefore we are buried with him by baptism in death, that like as Christ was raised up from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so should we walk in the newness of life. It was metaphorically used by Jesus when he walked and he talked with Nicodemus about the new birth. In St. John 3 and verse 5, Jesus answered, "Verily, verily, I say unto you, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God." Except a man be born of the water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. And I get a little deeper. Oh, hallelujah. To the woman that was at the sychar, the well, Christ spake to her of living water. St. John 4, verse 10 to 15. I read just a few verses there. Jesus answered and said unto her, "If thou knowest the gift of God and who it is that saith unto thee, give me to drink, thou wouldest have asked of him, and he would have given thee living water." O God of mercy. The woman said unto him, "Sir, thou hast nothing to draw with." Oh, glory to God. Somebody's questioning God this morning. Somebody's in dialogue with God like this woman. And let's continue the conversation. Sir, thou hast nothing to draw with, and the well is deep. From whence then hast thou that living water? Art thou greater than our father Jacob, which gave us the well, and drink thereof himself, and his children, and his cattle?" Jesus answered and said unto her, "Whosoever drinketh of this natural water, you're going to thirst again." Oh, God of mercy. "But whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst. But the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well springing up into everlasting life. There is a river. There is a spring. There is a life-giving source this morning. You may be drinking a long time. You are still thirsty because you are drinking at the wrong well. There is a well this morning. Oh, glory to God. Jesus is the person in charge. He said, come to the water. There is a vast supply. Yes, you drink. You thirst again. You drink. And you come again. Because you are not drinking from the source. You are not drinking from the life-giving stream. When the woman realized the many times she come to this well, a special well, given to them by Jacob, one of their forefathers. Jacob drank of it. His children drank from it. His cattle drank from it. It was a sentiment in the community. But the woman came that day, and when she stayed there and met Jesus. And now get in our life. You know our condition. Jesus, have mercy. She went through 5 husbands. She was on the 6th one. But she was still thirsty. Jesus, I love you. Oh God, have mercy. Some of us have gone to the extreme. Oh glory. Some of us have tried everything. But you're still thirsty. The first time in this woman's life, she saw a man like this. She said, who are you? Living water. Oh God, have mercy. I've never heard of this before. She said, give me this living water. When you get in contact with Jesus, there are conditions. She thought that was all there was to it. She was just going to get to the river. And to that well, she was just going to drink. But Jesus started getting her secret life. When you come to Jesus, Him expose. That's why some of us are afraid to come to the real life-giving stream. That's why some of us don't expose ourselves to the Holy Ghost. We are afraid of what God is going to reveal. There is no other way. Oh God, have mercy, Jesus. Somebody this morning is in desperation. You have tried and you have tried, but you have not tried the right source yet. Jesus is going to ask you a question. You have to tell Him the truth, because it's only the truth that is going to set you free. Where's your husband? I don't have any. Jesus didn't condemn her. He said, you have well spoken, because you have finished 5 and you are the 6th one now. And although you are with him on a few as somebody else's husband, you are trespassing on. But let me tell you something, woman. This day is your day. You will never be the same again. This day is your day of deliverance. Hey, glory to God. You have tried everything. You have gone through. Jesus, have mercy. Hey, I see somebody here this morning. Jesus, you have reached the very last straw that is going to break the camel's back. You come here this morning and you had a conversation with God. You said, God, I'm going to power up here this morning. And if something don't change in my life, this is it, God. I'm going to end it. You don't have to end it this morning. Hope is in the house. Jesus is here this morning. Come to the waters. Hey, glory to God. There is a vast supply. Jesus, you may be worse than the woman this morning, but Jesus will never turn you away. You can come just as you are. Living water. Just touch yourself and say, Jesus, give me to drink. Give me to drink. Living water. Living water. Water is also a biblical symbol of the Holy Spirit. St. John chapter 7, verse 37 to 39. In the last day, the great day of the feast, oh glory, Jesus stood and cried, saying, if any man, any woman, any boy, any girl, if any man thirst, oh God have mercy, let him come unto me and drink. He that believeth on me, as the scripture has said, out of his belly, oh God have mercy, Jesus, it's more than an emotion. Out of his belly shall flow rivers, not a stream that will dry up, not a tributary that will dry up, but rivers of living water. Oh, Yakosha, Moyabakosha, Nalabahaya, Merekeshekora Bahai, Jesus. Some persons only experience a stream experience. It runs for a little while, but as soon as the sun comes up, it saps the stream and the stream becomes dry. Some of us, we only have little tributaries, and it's only when the rain falls in abundance that little water trickles in our tributaries. And this is the reason why our spiritual lives becoming so cold, becoming so indifferent. But Jesus said this morning, the great day of the feast, if any man thirst, let him come unto me. Oh, glory to God. Oh, God. Jesus wants to place rivers in our bellies this morning. That when we speak, that when we walk, that when we be wherever we are, we'll be the issues of life to a lifeless community. Out of your bellies shall flow rivers of living water. Life, life, life. Hallelujah. Most of our churches, if they are not full, they have reasonable amount of people. But I ask the question this morning, how effective are we? What impact are we making on the wider communities? Is it a mere religiosity that we have and practice? Performing our rituals, our dogmas, our creeds? Or are we just going through the formalities as this church is so structured? When the people of the city, based on the scripture that I read from 2 Kings chapter 2, when the people of the city saw the condition and realized what was happening and know that it would not be very long before they all would have died, if things did not change, they came to the servant of God. They said, "Man of God, the situation of the city is pleasant." And that's where we are deceived. When it means pleasant, mean giving pleasure, satisfaction of the mind, feel our senses around, things around us. But what about you and I as a person? What is happening on the inside? We give a big smile. We put on our religious gorgeous. We perform our duties. We sit in the pews, look so sanctimonious and holy. But what's happening on the inside? What is taking place on the inside? We can put on our mask and fool, oh God, have mercy, those around us. But what sense does it make? He who sits high and looks low, he who searcheth the heart and tryeth the reins, he who knows the thought before they are even perceived. What standing are we with him this morning? Can he put his signature to our spiritual life? Can he endorse it and say, "Indeed, you are living up to my standard and my requirement"? Can he endorse it? The situation of the city, it is pleasant, looks very good to the eye, and everything around seems to be taking place and everything seems to be all right. But the greater concern, the water is not, meaning the water is of no worth or importance, a mere nothing. Good for nothing, worthless, useless, disregarded, disdained, because the water is polluted. The water is contaminated. The water will cause death if consumed by the people of the city. And because of that, the water cannot serve its purpose. So the ground become barren, unfruitful, not producing, unprofitable. It is fruitless. It is infertile. So we are not producing, because the water that is to give the life is spoiled. It's not. It's polluted. So it cannot serve the cause. And so because the sustenance of life is not in the right standing order to do its function and its work, there is none production. Nothing is happening. Barrenness. Barrenness. No fruit. Nothing. Jesus. God have mercy. Hallelujah. Oh God, hallelujah. And you ask me, what is the cause? What caused this? Some time ago, the trees were green. They bore all different different manner of fruit. The trees, the leaves were green and in all its glory. But now the trees are withered. The leaves have fallen. Oh, Jesus. Oh, God of mercy. Because the tree no longer drinks from that life-giving stream. And so life is going little by little by little. But you're asking me, what caused all of this downfall? And what caused all of this to be happening? Jeremiah 2 and verse 12 to 14. Jeremiah says, be astonished, O heavens, at this, and be horribly afraid. Be ye very desolate, said the Lord. For my people have committed two evils. First, they have forsaken me, the fountain. Oh God of mercy. Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Oh God. My people have committed two evils. First, they have forsaken me, the fountain of living waters, and have hewed out broken cisterns that can hold no water. Is Israel a servant? Is Israel a homeborn slave? Why is he spoiled? Because we have forsaken the fountain of living water. You're drinking from a source that is polluted. The living water that Jesus gives, we have forsaken. Every man have turned to their own way and doing their own thing, that which is right in their own eye, that which they take pleasure in because it seems right to them, and have forsaken the paths of righteousness. Broken cistern. If I take this glass and I drop it on the ground and break it, I guarantee you it will never be able to hold the water any longer. Some of us have dropped our cisterns. We have dropped our cisterns. They are broken. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. No water. Oh, God. Jesus. Broken. Broken. Can't hold the water again. We're going on. Oh, God, have mercy. But within us, we are dying. Morakosha, morekeshe, rabakosha, nalabaha. Jesus, Jesus. Oh, God. Oh, God. Jesus. In order for this glass to be of any use, it has to be whole. It has to be complete. Water is poured in, and I can drink. Break it, we have to discard it. It serves no more purpose. It becomes useless. no value. The Holy Spirit is saying to us this morning, even though the sister is broken, oh glory, God will not throw it away. I don't care how fine it may have splintered, because He cares. He will gather every bit, every particle. Oy. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, Yabakosha. Yeah, Yabakoshi and Alabahaya. Jesus. Nay. Heal me, Jesus. Heal my water, Jesus. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. As I prepare to close, the remedy, because we are forsaken and we have hewed out our own personal path and way, which is broken and of no value. The remedy, Ezekiel chapter 47. And I read a few verses there. Oh God. As I prepare to close. Afterward, he measured 1,000. And it was a river that I could not pass over. For the waters were risen, waters to swim in. A river that could not pass over. And he said unto me, Son of man, seest this? Then he brought me and caused me to return to the brink of the river. And when he had returned, behold, at the bank of the river were very many trees on the one side and on the other. Then said he unto me, these waters issued out towards the east country and go down into the desert, into the sea, which being brought forth into the sea, the waters shall be healed. And it shall come to pass that everything that liveth, which moveth, wheresoever the river shall come, shall live. And there shall be a very great multitude of fish, because these waters shall come thither, for they shall be healed, and everything shall live, whithersoever the river cometh. Jesus says to us this morning, we are at different stages. I did not read the previous verses, because you know it very well. From the threshing floor of the altar, the Son of Man came, and he brought Ezekiel. And when the first measurement was done, it came to the knee. But down to the knee, when the ankle, when the second one was done, came to the knee. When the third measurement was done, the water was to the loin. But at the fourth measurement, there was a river. Thank you, Jesus. The Holy Spirit says, somebody need to come back to the threshing floor of the altar. You're at your ankle, and that water is polluted, for there's no life. You're at your knee, but there's little or no life. You may even be at your loin. That's not enough. The Holy Spirit said, you need to come back one more time. God wants to break forth a river. Oh God. God of mercy. All the trees that are withered and have lost its leaves. All that is seen this morning is a trunk, an attractive, but the trunk is not yet dead. Job said at the scent of water, that trunk is going to spring again. The Holy Ghost is saying, I want to get you by my riverbank. I want you to send your main root out. Oh, glory to God. You're going to spring again. You're going to bud again. You're going to bear again. And not just fruit, but in that river, there are multitude of fish. You're going to feed the nation. Hey, oh, glory to God. Because I have healed the waters. Bow your heads. Oh God. Jesus. And when they came to Marah, according to Exodus 15, verse 23. And when they came to Marah, they could not drink of the water of Marah, for they were bitter. Therefore the name of it was called Marah. And the people murmured against Moses, saying, what shall we drink? What shall we drink? Thank you, Jesus. Somebody may be blaming somebody this morning and asking, what shall we drink? But God gave the servant of God instruction as he sought him. He dropped a branch from a tree in the water at Marah, and instantly the water became sweet, and the people of God was able to drink thereof. The Lord said, if thou wilt hearken diligently to the voice of the Lord thy God, and will do that which is right in his sight, and will give ears to his commandments, and keep his statutes, I will put none of these diseases upon thee, which I have wrought upon the Egyptian. For I am the Lord thy God that healeth thee. And they came to Elim, where there were 12 wells of water, and 70 palm trees, and they encamped. Marah, even if you have water, may be very bitter this morning. Bitter water. Oh God. Polluted water. Everything around you sick. Sick. Husband, wife, family, children, work environment. You're very tired. Your conversation. Sick. 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 Jesus. Sick. Sick. Oh God, Holy Ghost is here this morning. Holy Spirit said, come drink, come bathe, get filled, come swim, come get healed, come get deliverance, no more barrenness, no more drought. Oh God, no more death. Oh, the high kosha, medication, robo kosha, medeki and the labahaya. Hey, glory. The water is bad. Bitamara. Hey, abakosha, my abakusha. Bitamara. Hey, Jesus want to heal your water. Hey, Robo Koshi, Medekeshe, Robo Bakushi, hey, Oh, glory. Jesus, Jesus. Hey. Broken cistern. Jesus, Jesus. The repairer, the restorer is here this morning. Hey, Jesus, Jesus. Glory, glory. Heal me water, Jesus. Me water sick. Everything around me sick. Life is at stake. I can't continue like this. Life! Healing! Hey, hey! Oh, glory. Glory. Those in the audience, stand with me, please. If you feel like joining the others down here, you can join them. Come to the threshing floor. Come to the altar. River is flowing. River. Life. Life. Hey, 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 catch it. Life. Come. Come just as you are. Hear the Spirit call. Come receive. Come and live. Hallelujah. Life. Hey, 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 hey. Oh God, oh God. Jesus, Jesus. Come, 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 come. Come, run, come. Jesus. Not pretend no longer. Hey! Jesus. Jesus. Hey. Jesus. Jesus. Just reach out. Throw yourself on him. Tell him you're dying. Tell him you need life. Tell him you need healing. Tell him. Jesus. Oh God. Oh, oh God. Out of your belly. Out of your belly. Out of your innermost being. Jesus. Oh God. Jesus. My God. Oh. 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 Jesus. My God. My God. Yes, Lord. Oh God. Jesus. Jesus. This river will never stop. This river is continuous. This river, when you get in contact with it, you will never be the same again. Come to these waters. There is a vast supply. You want to drink this morning. You are thirsty. Your lips are parched dry. Your soul inside of you is crying out this morning. You long, you yearn. You want something to come alive on the inside again. You long to feel that sweet, sweet anointing. You long to get in touch, a heavenly connection. Oh God, Jesus. Oh God, you're merely just surviving. God wants to give you living water, abundant life this morning. Oh God, Rabba Kosha. Jesus, 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 Jesus. There is a river that flows from deep within. There is a fountain that cleanses the heart from sin. Come to these waters. There is a vast supply. Come, 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 come. Open up, open up. River is running. River is flowing. Life is here. Deliverance is here. Healing is here. Claim your victory now. Jesus. Oh God. Oh God. Jesus. Yes, Lord. Pour it out, Jesus. Pour out life. Pour out life. Real life. Abundant life. Heal every sickness, God. Spiritually sick. Sick, Lord. Sick. Sick. Sick with backbiting. Sick with covetousness. secret fornication, secret adultery, secret lying, secret stealing, secret covetousness. Oh God, heal us. The water is polluted. Hey, Jesus. Sin pollutes. Sin contaminates. Heal us. Hey, Rababakoshi and Rabahaya. Jesus, 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 Holy Ghost of God. Hey, worldliness taking over, destroying the spirit. Jesus, take hold of worldliness, take care of worldly manifestation. Let the Holy Ghost come alive again. Help us to lay aside every weight and sin which so easily beset us. You search the heart. You try the reins. Heal us. Holy Ghost of God. Lay.
Thirsty woman came drawing from the well. There she met the master. Her joys no man could tell. He told her of this water that he would give her then. And because of his great power, she would never thirst again. There is a river that flows from deep within. There is a fountain that cleanses my soul from sin. Let us come to this water. There is a vast supply. There is a river that never shall run dry. Everybody say there is a river that flows from deep within. There is a fountain. Hallelujah, cleanse my soul from sin. I will come to the water. There is a vast supply. Glory, a river that never shall. I said there was a thirsty woman came drawing from the well. But there she met the master. Her joys no man could tell. Jesus told her of the water that he would give her then. And because of his great power, she would never thirst again. Oh, there is a river. Oh, somebody reach out in the river. There in Ezekiel's mighty stream. There in Ezekiel's mighty stream, pump. To this water, church, there is a vast supply. I said there is a river, and it never shall. Lift up all your hands and sing it again. There is there a thirsty soul? Water of life is flowing. Is there a dying tree? Is there a dying tree? Oh, there is a vast supply. There. Hallelujah. And it never shall run dry. Everybody reach out and talk to God now. Come on, reach out and talk to God. Reach out and talk to God. Reach out and drink. Reach out and drink. Dive in and dive. Jump in and swim. Receive your healing. Healing for body and soul it will bring. Talk to God, everybody. Father, in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, our waters need to be healed. And you are the fountain of living water. There's no stagnation to you. There's no death to you. There's no barrenness to you. There's no infestation to you. Oh, God. Let somebody today drink from the fountain. Drink from the river. Draw from the well. Hallelujah. Situation of the city is pleasant. Superficially we look at it. Oh, but the water is not and the ground barren. But God, you have a word. You send us a word of healing. A word of deliverance. A word of hope. A word to bring restoration. Oh God, heal these waters, Lord. Heal the many waters that are sick. Spiritual waters, family waters, financial waters, marital waters, social waters, economic waters. Heal the waters of this nation. In the name of Jesus, let somebody's stream flow again. Let somebody's fountain flow again. God, let even somebody's tributary flow again. For many things are dried up. Oh, God, hallelujah. Ramasokorobo seterebehunda. Rokoshibaba sikataramaha. By the mighty power of Jesus Christ. Oh, yes, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Heal Jesus. Heal Jesus. Heal Jesus. Yeah. Someone here needs help. but I can't do much. But if we keep on praising, He'll send us Holy Ghost tongue. It brings healing for body and soul, it will bring. For I came on business for the King.
Somebody better receive that healing today.
For I came on business. Elisha Bako sent me up. He told me to smile. He told me I feel God moving up and down this place. Healing for body and soul it will.
Get it, get it, get it, get it, get it.
For I came.
Hey, Yosamaha,
for the King. Yes, I came on business
for the King, King of Kings and Lord of Lords.
He told me to smile. Jesus told me to sing. Church, I can't just stand here and do my own thing. For I came on business for the King.
I did say someone here needs help. What a triumph!
And I can't do. But if we keep on praising,
He will send us Holy Ghost touch right now.
It brings healing for my body and soul it will bring. For I came on business of.
Lift up both of your hands, everybody, and throw yourself in the river.
I came.
Jump out by faith in the Spirit. Healing time. Restoration time. Hey!
He told me, get it, get it, get it.
Smile.
He told me to sing.
Yes, God is moving.
For I came. Just stand there and do my own.
You better get that dip.
For I came on business.
I'm going to sing it one more time. Reach out and touch him.
I said, someone here needs help. But I can't do much.
I'm so feeble myself.
But if we keep on praising, He will send us, His touch. Healing for my body and my soul it will bring. For I came on business for the King.
Lift up your hands now and reach out and touch it. Business!
I came.
Business time! Business! Business time! Serious business!
He told me to smile.
The joy!
Told me I must sing. For I came. Standing, my own thing. Go, devil, go. The blood of Jesus is against you. We bind you in the name of Jesus. We rebuke you. We rebuke you, devil. Devil, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Take your filthy hands off. Your hand of discouragement, I rebuke you. Your hand of sinful practices, I rebuke you. In the name of Jesus, I rebuke you, Satan. I rebuke you, devil. I rebuke unclean spirit. I rebuke unclean practices. I rebuke them now. Let the river flow. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Father, we just thank you and praise you for what you have done. For the mighty move of your Holy Spirit upon your people. Save the lost, reclaim the backsliders. Heal the sick and strengthen the believers. And grant that every dry, thirsty, parched ground today will become a fertile spot, an oasis in this desert. You shall get the glory, the praise, and the honor. In Jesus' name, clap your hands and praise Him. Go back to your seats and claim the victory. Walk in the Spirit. Walk in the Spirit. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yeah. He says, come to the water and stand by my side and drink from the fountain. You every teardrop that fell from your heart, and I hope to tell you for those tears I got. Jesus said, come to the water and stand by my side and drink. From the fountain you will be denied. He said, I've seen every tear that fell from your eyes, and I wrote to tell you for those tears. He says, come that you might your sins.
Lift up your hand and sing it again. He said, come
to
joy comes in the morning.
Joy comes in the morning.
Know that God is nigh.
Know that God is nigh.
Don't try to fight the battle yourself, but stand still, and look up. God is going to show up. He's standing right by.
He's standing by.
We want to say that one more time for somebody who may be discouraged. Don't be discouraged.
Because
joy is on the way. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Know that God is now. That God is going to show up.
God is going to show up.
He is standing right by.
He is standing by.
For those of you who may not know it, there's healing.